And Jesus spake a parable to certain people who trusted in themselves for salvation, considering themselves righteous, despising all other people.
Mother, why does Father go to the temple and pray so often?
Oh, your father is a good man, my dear.
Oh, I know that, but why does he go to the temple and pray? Can't he pray right here at home? Or won't God hear him from here?
Oh, he must go to the temple, dear, so he can be seen by other people.
Can't other people pray for themselves?
Oh, yes, of course, dear, but, well, we're Pharisees. We must be examples to other people.
Yes, I know we're Pharisees. The girl down the street's always making fun of me and calling me a Pharisee.
She's a Sadducee, so don't you pay any attention to her.
What's the difference between Pharisees and Sadducees?
Oh, we're just not at all the same.
We're all Israelites, aren't we?
Yes, dear.
Then why are we different?
Well, I'll try to explain if you'll listen.
I will, Mother. I want to know.
Well, the difference, of course, is in our religion. We Pharisees believe God watches over us and cares what we do.
He does, doesn't he?
Oh, yes, very carefully. That's why we must do exactly as he has ordered. God is very strict about that, and he'll punish us for the tiniest disobedience.
How do we know what God wants us to do?
Well, my dear, that's one of the most important lessons that we must learn. By two ways, the law of Moses and the tradition of the elders. There's no other way to salvation. And that's why your father goes to the temple to pray, to let others know that we are saved, that our way is right. All other ways are wrong, my dear. In fact, we despise all other ways and people.
And what does that girl believe?
The Sadducees? Oh, they believe in nothing, really. Oh, they hardly believe in a God. They picture him as paying little attention to men and taking little interest in their affairs.
How do they know what's good and what's bad?
Oh, they don't. They do as the world does. But we don't. We do as God wants. That's why we're better than they are, and why we look down upon everyone else as not being worthy of a second thought.
So that's why Father goes to the temple and stands where everyone can see him and hear him pray. So everyone will know that we're better than they are. I have a good father.
I stand before thee, O God, in righteousness and holiness. O God, art thou not thankful that a perfect Pharisee like me comes before thee to worship? I am incomparably superior to the common people. I have many virtues, O God. For these I am thankful, and also I am sure they endear me to thyself. I am grateful that by myself and my own willpower and strength, I have kept strictly within the letter of the law. Unlike other men, I am not an extortioner, unjust, adulterer, or as low and evil as the publican. I have many other things to my credit, O God. I fast twice each week. I pay tithe, O Lord, more tithe than the Mosaic law requires. Credit this to my account, O God, and I shall continue to pay tithe on those things that I myself, by my own hard labor, acquired. I stand before thee, O God, a Pharisee, perfect in all things.
Why do those other children call me that publican?
Because I am a tax collector, my son. A publican.
But they make fun of me. Why?
Son, I guess they have the right to.
Why, Father? Why?
Because I am a publican.
Are publicans bad?
People think so.
Well, I don't. I think you're the best father in the whole wide world. And I love Mother, too.
It isn't what we are, son, that people hate about us. It's what we do.
What do we do?
I'm a tax collector.
Why would they hate us for that? Someone has to collect taxes, don't they?
Yes, but, well, we collect more than we have to.
Oh, well, stop then, and people won't hate us.
I I can't stop.
You just said you collect more than you have to.
I do, yet I don't. I mean, it's the system. The chief tax collector here pays Rome a certain amount for the privilege of collecting taxes. He sends Rome that much. Well, he can't collect for nothing. He has to live. So he collects more than he sends to Rome.
I don't see anything wrong with that.
People call it extortion, stealing.
Is it stealing? Really stealing, Father?
Well, it goes much deeper than that, son. I collect two kinds of taxes. So much per person and so much per lot of ground. Both kinds are offensive to the Israelites. One, because they think it shows enslavement to Rome. The other, because they consider that this land belongs to God, not Rome.
Well, I don't see why they should hate us so much for that.
No, son. They are right. We are pretty low. I am an Israelite, and I collect from the Israelites to give to Rome. And also to put in my own pocket.
Why don't you stop being a publican?
It's no use to. Well, the Israelites would never forget. They would never accept me as one of them, nor forgive me.
Will God?
Well, I'm not sure, but I hope so.
Have you ever asked him?
Of course, son, but I'm so sinful and unworthy that God could never hear my prayers as he does the Pharisees.
Have you ever tried it? Standing up there by the temple like they do and praying real loud? God can't help but hear you.
Oh, no, son. I could never do that. I'm not worthy. When I pray, I stand far off. Oh, God, have mercy upon me, for I am not worthy even to lift my eyes heavenward. God, be merciful to me, a sinner.
Jesus said,
I tell you, this man went down to his house justified rather than the other. For every one that exalteth himself shall be abased, and he that humbleth himself shall be exalted.